Hey, welcome to the Explainer. You know that feeling, right? An app crashes just when you need it most, or your work software is just impossibly slow. We always blame the tech itself, but you know what? The real magic, the real problem, is usually in how that tech is managed. So today, we're going to pull back the curtain on IT service management. It's kind of the invisible engine that decides if your digital world runs like a dream or, you know, a total nightmare. So, to get our heads around this, let's start with a totally different question. Why would you ever hire a professional to manage your money? I mean, for most of us, the answer is pretty simple. We just don't have the time or the super deep financial expertise. And let's be honest, the desire to track every little market change day in and day out.
Right. And that relationship is built on a really simple idea. You focus on the outcome, you know, growing your savings, and you trust an expert to handle all the complex day-to-day stuff. You're not really paying them just to make trades. You're paying for the value they deliver. And that right there, that's the perfect way to think about how modern tech services work.
And this brings us right to the official definition of a service. At its core, it's just a way of delivering value to a customer by helping them get what they want, but without forcing them to own all the specific costs and risks that come with it. The provider, they take on all that complexity so that the customer doesn't have to. Simple as that.
Okay, so if a service is all about delivering value, the next question is pretty obvious. How do organizations actually get good at it? And that's where we shift from the what to the how, the real art of management.
Service management isn't just a department or some team tucked away in a corner. Nope, it's a professional discipline. It's a whole set of skills and processes that an organization builds up over time. You should think of it like accounting or human resources. It's one of those core capabilities that helps the whole business run by delivering value through services.
So we've been throwing that word value around a lot, but what does it actually mean when we're talking about a service? Well, it turns out value isn't just one thing. It's more of an equation with two really critical parts. It's this constant balance between what a service does and how well it actually does it.
Think of these two components like, I don't know, peanut butter and jelly. They have to work together perfectly. If you only have one, the whole thing just falls apart and you don't really get any value.
Let's break this down. On one side, you've got utility. Is the service fit for purpose? Does it have the features you actually need to get the job done? Then on the other side, you have warranty. Is it fit for use? Is it available when you need it? Is it secure? Is it fast enough? I mean, seriously, what good is some cutting-edge photo editing app if it's always crashing or it's too slow to even use? That's the huge difference between utility and warranty. And this quote just hits the nail on the head. You absolutely need both. An incredibly reliable service that doesn't actually do what you need is, well, it's just reliably useless. And a service with all the bells and whistles that's always down, that's just a headache. Real value only happens when utility and warranty are perfectly in sync.
Okay, so to deliver a service that has both awesome utility and rock-solid warranty, a provider needs the right building blocks. And that brings us to the two fundamental types of assets that every single service is built from: resources and capabilities.
And these building blocks, they fall into two very, very different categories. See, it's not just about having the right stuff. It's about having the right skills to actually use that stuff well.
On one hand, you have resources. These are the tangible things you can just go out and buy. We're talking servers, software licenses, infrastructure. But on the other hand, you have capabilities. And these are intangible. This is the collective knowledge, the fine-tuned processes, the experience your organization has earned. You can't just go out and buy world-class project management, right? That's a capability you have to build and nurture over a long time.
And here it is, the key takeaway. It's the capabilities, that intangible know-how, that act as the secret sauce. They are what transform a big pile of resources into a service that actually delivers real value to a customer.
So we have the assets, our resources and capabilities, but now let's talk about the people. Because to get the full picture, we really need to meet the key players in any service ecosystem.
First up, you've got the customer. This is the person or group who defines what's needed and, you know, pays the bills. They're all about the overall value. Then you have the user. This is the person on the front lines, clicking the buttons, interacting with the service every single day. And finally, you have suppliers. Those are the third parties providing all the essential hardware, software, or network connections that make the service possible in the first place. Understanding all their different points of view is absolutely critical.
So there you have it. You've got the toolkit. You understand the value equation, that's utility and warranty. You know the building blocks, resources, and capabilities.
and you know the key players in the whole ecosystem. So the next time you use an app that just feels flawless, or one that constantly drives you crazy, ask yourself, how are they managing this service? Because now you know exactly what to look for.